Hi everyone, my name is Yuvraj Narula and welcome back to Unphenomenal and Major Nani's Kitchen. The dish that which we are going to make today is masala cheese balls, and that is absolutely amazing and tasty dish with purely Indian flavors. And let's get started. At first, we would be making a potato mixture for our cheese balls, and for that we require 1.5 big potato which is boiled nicely and mashed. And now we would not be adding much things into it. Very simple, the potato mixture should be very nice and smooth. We would be adding approximately 1.5 tablespoons of maida, all-purpose flour, and 1 tablespoon of semolina or suji. And I'm also adding salt to taste. That is it, we will just mix it very nicely. For making the cheese filling, I have taken 3 cheese cubes, processed cheese cubes, which I have taken of Amul, and I have grated them. And now I would be adding other things into it. I would be adding half a teaspoon of red chili powder and coriander powder and very little shahi jeera. Now I would be adding 2-3 drops of lemon juice, 2-3 leaves of mint, and a bit more quantity of coriander leaves. And now I would just mix it nicely like a dough. Two tablespoons of vegetable oil, I have made all the balls from the cheese mixture. These size of lemon size balls I've made, and now I will be keeping it in the fridge for 10 to 15 minutes until it's firm enough so that if we fry it, it doesn't ooze out of the. Now for making the cheese balls like this, I have prepared some of them already. And for making cheese balls, we would be taking a small amount of potato mixture in our hands. We will flatten it out nicely. That it doesn't have a lot of cracks, and the layer should not be very thick. We have to give a very thin coating of potato over our cheese balls. So we will be placing our cheese ball, which was in the fridge for last 15 minutes. It is quite firm, and I will just put it inside this like this, and we will just do it again and again like this. Make sure that it doesn't have any cracks. It should be smooth from all the sides, and there should be no lumps in it. So that is it, we are done with making our cheese balls, and we will keep this cheese balls again in the fridge for 10 to 15 minutes. And please make sure that you do not skip the steps of keeping it in the fridge, because that would be tougher for you also to work with cheese. Now for the final coating of our cheese balls. These cheese balls I have taken out from the fridge, and I would just take one cheese ball, reshape it once again lightly, not pressing it very hardly with my hands. Now here I have taken half a cup of slurry, which I have made from, I have taken half a cup of water, and I have added 2 tablespoons of all-purpose flour or maida in it and whisked nicely to make a slurry. And here I have 3-4 breadcrumb. And you can take panko breadcrumbs also if you want. That gives a very. Now we need to dip the cheese ball into the slurry and then coat the breadcrumbs evenly from all the sides so that it is nice and crisp when we fry it. Now as you can see that all the cheese balls are well coated in breadcrumbs. Now we are ready to fry this in a medium hot oil.